Fighting wildfires is no easy task. People and equipment typically have to be moved hundreds of miles. While the Southwest region has to share firefighting resources, there are some things they don't want to share. First Alert meteorologist Eric Green takes us to Pecos.
Wildfires can pop up in very remote areas, and there aren't exactly fire hydrants on the street corner to grab water from to battle the blazes, so they end up having to use whatever water is available.
Out here in the wildlands, so anything that has water in it, we try to make available to us, whether that be a pond, either private or public pond, stream, river. Don't see too many lakes up here, so yeah, wherever we can tap water from.
Up here in the Pecos, airdrops from helicopters come from scooping water out of where they can find it, and fire engines are also filled with this local wild water that is clean from a mountain stream, but it's not treated water like what comes out of your faucet at home.
All of the equipment and hoses that are being used to fight this fire are then washed in this big pool of bleach water, and the bleach water kills off a couple species they don't want leaving this area. One is a plant called rock snot, and the other is a parasite called whirling disease.
The engines come in, or the water tenders come in, they'll actually draft the water out of the tank, put it into their tank, run it through their pump, all their fittings that they have, and then discharge it back into the tanks.
This bleach water only needs a couple minutes to do its job, making sure that the slimy rock snot and fish altering whirling disease are killed before this equipment is moved to the next wildfire that needs fighting. I'm First Alert meteorologist Eric Green, KOAT Action 7 News.
The Southwest region that shares firefighting resources with New Mexico includes all of Arizona and western parts of Oklahoma and Texas.